Hey everyone, so this video is about the book David and Goliath by Malcolm Gladwell. If you're interested in the book, there's a link down below. So basically, this book is all about how there are advantages to having a disadvantage, or the flip side is how there are disadvantages to having an advantage. And basically, he talks about how we usually think of and having an advantage is a good thing, but that's actually not necessarily the case as he describes in this book. And actually there are advantages of having a disadvantage. So just like in other books by Malcolm Gladwell, he only really has two main points in this book. And one of the main points is that if you have a disadvantage and you know you have a disadvantage and you're going up against someone who has an advantage, then in order to really sort of compete competitively, then you're going to have to start thinking creatively. Now, he talks about how this has been the case in the past where people would go to war with each other, and the team or the side that were disadvantaged, they lost because they were trying to fight the team or the country that had the advantage on a conventional level or on a norm, right? And so that's what he was saying. In order to fight or in order to win against those who have the upper hand, you have to think creatively. And he talks about that on page 32 in the book. And he basically says that there are the battles that the two big battles that took place. One is the American Revolution, and the second is the Vietnam War, right? So in the American Revolution, George Washington, he thought creatively. He fought in a guerrilla warfare style. And that's the same thing with Vietnam. In the Vietnam War, the Vietnamese had to think creatively, so they also fought in a guerrilla warfare style, right? So they knew they were outnumbered, they knew they didn't have the same sort of technology as the Americans, so they thought, okay, how can we win this battle? And so they fought somewhat unconventionally, right? So that's point number one. If you're at a disadvantage and you know it going into a fight, then you got to think creatively on how you can beat the other person. Now, the second point to his book is called the inverted U curve. And basically, this is the law of diminishing returns. Now, basically, what that means is after a certain amount of something, you no longer get the same sort of results as you did in the beginning. Now, example, think of your favorite food. Maybe it's steak, or maybe it's pasta, or maybe it's pizza, you know, and you're really craving it. So after you have it, you feel really good. And then, you know, let's just say it's one slice of steak or one slice of pizza or something like that, right? So you have your slice of pizza, you finish it, you're feeling good. And then the second piece, you know, you might feel like, okay, I can eat it. And then you feel good. And then the third piece, you're just going to feel like, okay, maybe I probably shouldn't eat this, but I'll have it anyways. All right. And then so on and so forth, right? So after a certain point, the satisfaction that you get from it somewhat goes down. And I'm sure that's the same case with this pizza example. So by the time you're eating 10 slices of pizza, you're probably, you know, you're throwing up. You're just like, oh, I don't want this anymore, right? So that's basically what he's talking about. And on page 52, he actually shows you what it looks like. It's right over here, this inverted U-shaped curve, right? So after a certain point, the returns that you get from it isn't necessarily going to add extra results or add anything, any sort of benefit after a certain point. So who is this book for? Now, I would say that this book here is for someone who is interested in learning about how underdogs are able to take out the big people, right? So if you're interested in reading on stories about that, then definitely check out this book. Other than that, there aren't really many good pieces of information or good points to this book. They're all just filled with stories. And if you're someone who loves a story of an underdog, then definitely check out this book. In terms of my rating, I would give it maybe a 3.9 out of 5. It's not exactly one of the best books I've read, but it's not bad either. But so that's why I would give it a 3.9 out of 5. All right, well, thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. If you didn't, then give it a thumbs down. Or leave a comment below on what you liked about it or what you didn't like about this video. That way I can improve and make these videos better for you. All right, well, if you are interested in receiving notifications of my future videos, then hit that subscribe button down below. And yeah, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.